on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, UK, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat. In English, Punjabi and Gujarati, with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are... In India, the shutdown over the Sabarimala temple has crippled life in Kerala. And the Shiv Sena will not contest the forthcoming Lok Sabha polls with the BJP. In UK, Prime Minister Theresa May extend the post-Brexit transition period. And British Indian World War II spy Noor Inayat Khan may be the next face of the British currency. In Punjab, Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has met Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And the mastermind behind the conspiracy to target former Chief Minister Prakash Singh Badal has been nabbed. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, UK and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are... The day-long shutdown called by the BJP and Sabarimala Protection Council crippled normal life in Kerala on Thursday. This was to protest the blatant charge by police and violence at the base camps of the Sabarimala temple. The hilltop shrine, however, continued to remain inaccessible to women. Shiv Sena Chief Uddhav Thackeray has reiterated that his party would go it alone in the forthcoming Lok Sabha elections, which are likely to be held early next year. Thackeray asked Shiv Sena workers to begin working in every constituency in Maharashtra. The BJP has said that the Congress was running a Modi Hatao campaign in Pakistan and accused it of demeaning and defaming the Hindu community in India. The party alleged that the Congress was deliberately targeting the Hindus for crying foul over glorification of terrorists in university campuses. The government has said that there is no threat of discontinuation of mobile numbers issued using Aadhaar. This is following the Supreme Court ruling that barred the use of national biometric ID by private companies. A Delhi court took judicial note of MJ Akbar's criminal defamation complaint against journalist Priya Ramani, who accused him of sexual misconduct around 20 years ago. It will record the statement of the former minister on October 31st in the case. RSS Chief Mohan Bhagwat has pitched for building a grand Ram temple in Ayodhya at the earliest. He has called for an appropriate and requisite law and slammed fundamentalist forces for obstructing the process. Three-time former Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister and an ex-Chief Minister of Uttarakhand, N.D. Tiwari, died on his 93rd birthday in the capital on Thursday. Tiwari breathed his last following a multi-organ failure. United Jihad Council Chief Sayyed Salahuddin has said that armed struggle in Kashmir had become inevitable and the only way to break the government's arrogance. He alleged that New Delhi was never interested in the peaceful resolution of Kashmir issue. A truck driver died after his vehicle collided with the Thiruvananthapuram Hazrat Nizamuddin Rajdhani Express. It derailed two coaches at a manned level, crossing between Gujarat's Godhra and Madhya Pradesh Ratlam. Restoration work is currently underway. Actress Kajol believes that the strong performance of female-fronted films at the ticket window has forced producers to rethink their strategy. She says that producers were earlier reluctant to back such projects because the box office response was not very encouraging for such films, though they garnered good reviews. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as news from UK and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from UK are... Prime Minister Theresa May is considering a European Union proposal that will keep Britain bound to the bloc's rules for more than 2 years after it leaves. However, the idea has angered May's pro-Brexit critics in UK. British Indian World War II spy Noor Inayat Khan may be the next face of British currency. A campaign for save is gaining momentum, wherein people are demanding the spy to be featured on a redesigned £50 currency note. Brexit Secretary Dominic Raab has riled some MPs after appearing to suggest that the Parliament might not get a so-called meaningful vote on any deal. Meanwhile, some MPs want the right to amend whatever Prime Minister Theresa May comes back with from Brussels. The Labour leadership has distanced itself from suggestions by some Labour MPs that Brexit is more important than dealing with bullying in Commons. Several top leaders have claimed that John Bercow must stay on as Speaker to ensure that the MPs have a decisive say on UK's EU exit. A case of BSC or the so-called mad cow disease has been confirmed at a farm in Scotland. A movement ban is now in place on the unnamed farm. Investigations are underway to identify the origin of the disease. Top government advisor Alan Manning has said that farmers should no longer get privileged access to low-skilled, low-paid workers from EU after Brexit. Manning has said that food and vegetable growers will probably go backwards. Home Home Office data has revealed that recorded crime has gone up by 9% in England and Wales, fueled by rises in violent offences and robbery. The data shows that police forces in England and Wales registered a total of 5.6 million offences in the year to June. Measures to help protect cyclists are expected to be included in the new Highway Code. These include encouraging people to adopt the Dutch reach, which is the method of opening the car door using the hand furthest from handle. It forces drivers to turn and look behind for passing cyclists. Oxford University's Conservative Association has overturned a ban on members of Willingdon Club. The association last week put club on its list of proscribed organisations. Former PM David Cameron and several other leaders were members of the club. Gloucester number 8 Ben Morgan is included in England's squad for Autumn Internationals, but there is no place for teammate Danny Cipriani. Morgan had last featured for England in 2015, but earns a place amid a back row injury crisis. I'll be back. Stay locked on to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has met Prime Minister Narendra Modi and demanded the centre's help for farmers in lieu of stubble burning. Singh also urged the centre to settle the outstanding food cash credit account. The Patiala police, in a joint operation with Rajasthan police, arrested the mastermind behind the conspiracy to target former Chief Minister Prakash Singh Badal. The accused, identified as Jarman Singh, was caught from his residence in Uttar Pradesh. 10-year-old Arshdeep Singh has won the Wildlife Photographer of the Year award for his picture Pipe Owls in his age category at the National History Museum, London. Arshdeep, who hails from Jalandhar, said that he shot the picture in Kapurthala. The SGPC executive meeting at Sultanpur Lodi holds significance as the issue of replacing Akal Takht Jathedar might be considered. Reports have surfaced that due to ill health, Jathedar Gyani Gurbachan Singh intends to quit and has asked SAD leadership to find a replacement. Two cabinet ministers have expressed displeasure over a delay in action against the SAD for their alleged complicity in sacrilege incidents and subsequent police firing at Behbal Kalan and Kotkapura. The ministers expressed concern that people are irked over the government's inaction. An SIT probing the firing at Behbal Kalan and Kotkapura have met Panthik leaders and recorded statements of 12 cops. More than 50 victims and witnesses also got their statements recorded as the SIT fast-tracked the investigation. The state has joined the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana scheme. The financial health protection scheme under Ayushman Bharat Mission now covers all states except four. The Uttar Pradesh police are not ruling out the possibility of sleeper modules of pro-Khalistan terror outfits being active in the state's Khadar region. Three Khalistani sympathizers were arrested in an encounter in Shamli. The cabinet has approved the much-awaited Punjab State Sand and Gravel Policy 2018. This aims at capping transportation costs and sale price of sand and gravel to end user. The makers of Marriage Palace have finally unveiled the release date of the movie. Starring Shahri Maan and Payal Rajput in lead, the movie will hit big screens on 23rd November. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-UK businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Grammy and Oscar-winning composer A.R. Rahman says working with superstar Shah Rukh Khan on Jai Hind Hind Jai India was an interesting experience. Rahman directed Shah Rukh for the first time for the official video of the official song for Odisha Hockey Men's World Cup Bhubaneswar 2018. The song is composed by Rahman and penned by Gulzar. Rahman said in a statement, "Gulzarji and I are extremely excited to share with you our latest song Jai Hind Hind Jai India. Having Shah Rukh join us made it even more interesting. I hope you enjoy the music video produced by our young team. It is a music video that my team and I have created after nearly two decades of having created Vande Mataram. Jai India has given me the privilege of singing in India's honour as we get ready to host the Hockey World Cup in Odisha next month." The song and video are slated to release at the end of the month. Rahman will also perform it live at the opening ceremony on November 27th. There has been immense buzz surrounding his coming wedding with actress Deepika Padukone. But Bollywood star Ranveer Singh says his focus in life right now is acting and films. Ranveer told IANS in an email interview, "Right now I am focused on work that I am doing in films. I am doing back-to-back films. I have been very blessed to have some really amazing projects at hand and I tremendously value these opportunities. I want to do my bit to contribute towards the filmmaking process and to try and make the best films possible. So, my focus in life right now is acting and films." Ranveer says finding a place in Bollywood was a tough task. At the moment, he is working on Zoya Akhtar's Gully Boy, Rohit Shetty's Simba and Kabir Khan's 83. Actress Aishwarya Rai Bachchan, who supported a Women's Cancer Initiative event, says people generally need to be more aware about the disease as early detection can give them a better chance at a cure. The actress and former Miss World pointed out that there are many myths in the country about cancer as a disease.
Events such as these is what has us come together to draw attention and raise awareness, increase dialogue, get people information, make it more accessible to them.
She applauded WCI's event for supporting and taking care of various issues related to cancer, especially amongst underprivileged women. Actress Rani Mukherjee, who was seen alongside Shah Rukh Khan and Kajol in filmmaker Karan Johar's Kuch Kuch Hota Hai 20 years back, reveals how the director-producer harassed her on the sets of the said movie. Sharing some behind-the-scenes experience, Rani said,
"He has harassed me in the movie. I remember."
No, I just told
you. He's really special. He's feeling very special right now.
He has harassed me because he has snatched my plate of food, which I was eating in the morning of the shot that keeps coming in the trailer, which is my orange short top and short skirt. And I remember Manish and Karan walking by, and I was sitting with, I think, the junior artist, and I was eating my breakfast, and they both looked at me and gone, "Huh? You can't eat that. Remove the plate from my hand. Remove the plate from my hand." And they actually snatched my plate. And then Manish became like very nice and said, "No, no, you can't snatch a plate. Give the food back to her."
"No, no, we called the room service and said not to give you food."
Well, it was just a light moment they shared on the movie sets. Meanwhile, on film front, Rani was last seen in Hitchki, which is now released in China too and has opened to extremely good reviews overseas. We all know that actor Siddharth Malhotra sees a mentor and a father figure in filmmaker Karan Johar, who also introduced the actor in the film Dum with Student of the Year. However, Malhotra now reveals that there was a time when Johar actually shattered his dreams. Siddharth, at the celebration of 20 years of Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, said,
"That day I realized two things. One, that my mum is dressing me all wrong. And the other, that my school was clearly not as happening as the Kuch Kuch Hota Hai St. Xavier's. Of course, much later I realized that that was what I saw was a product of Karan Johar's impossible imagination by the maverick Manish Malhotra. Anyhow, all thanks to that, Karan, you shattered my dreams of a college life forever. I looked tirelessly for a colorful campus, for hip and cool lockers, for girls dressed like Rani Mukherjee, and buddies like Kajol, who played basketball like a star."
Well, post Student of the Year, Karan and Siddharth continued to collaborate for movies like Ittefaq, Kapoor and Sons, Baar Baar Dekho, among others.